Theia's quest to the Midwest.
I am on a quest to see everything that the Midwest has to offer. From cool sights you can't see anywhere else, to delicious culinary experiences you'll want to try for yourself. I'm Thayer Craner, and come with me as I get to explore the Midwest for the very first time. Today, we're diving deep to uncover the secrets of Rochester, Minnesota's mysterious subway system. And there yet remains another structure called the Skywalks, which connect buildings over the roads that we'll be observing today. And so it was that I found myself at the gate of the subway system. I stepped into a dimension devoid of life. The remains of a civilization now long lost lined every wall, from the Caribou Coffee to the Auntie Anne's Pretzels. The halls were completely devoid of human life. Yet here in the subway, such abandon was not just haunting, but beautiful. After traveling for what felt like days on foot, I ran into my first sign of human life. Who was this mysterious man? This lost soul of the subway system? And where did he come from? The world may never know. Again, shortly after, yet another lost soul was sighted. I could only think of one reason why anybody would be here. And that's to visit Hanny's of Rochester, Minnesota, the coolest retro clothing store in the subway system down below. Being the only store open in the subway, Hanny's has a variety of really cool t-shirts and patterned button-downs. Even the owner was cool. Check this out.
It is a probably 1970s police scanner.
Oh, wow. That's really cool.
And then the little device on the top of it is a one of the first fuzzbusters or radar detectors.
Fuzzbuster.
That you'd have in your car.
I like that. I like the name of that.
All he did was he just got the setting right, and then when the police were trying to catch you speeding, there was a giant red light that would go off. So that was like the first one.
That's very cool.
Yeah.
I had a really great time looking through all of these fancy clothes. I mean, the patterns and the designs on all of them were truly spectacular, but it's a bit above my price range. As awesome as these clothes were, I just had to depart into the rest of the subway, where I discovered a veterans assembly and then made my way up to the Skywalk for the first time. Spectacular and serene, letting in the light and the sights of Rochester, Minnesota. They provide people a warm crossway, both the Skywalks and subways, during those harsh Rochester, Minnesota winters. Before I investigated more of the Skywalks and where they connected, I had a little bit more of the subway to explore, like this abandoned business called the Chocolate Oasis, and then a mysterious hallway, one which may have led directly underneath the Mayo Clinic, and tells the story of the Carillon, Minnesota's largest instrument, located in the tower above the Plummer Building in Rochester, Minnesota. For those of you who don't know, the Mayo Clinic has historically been known to be one of the highest-ranked hospitals in the United States for cancer, cardiology, and so many other fields of research and science. The Mayo brothers were veterans of World War I who founded the Mayo Clinic, and the massive tower that sits above Plummer Building, home to the 56 Bell Carillon, it stands as a memorial to those who died fighting in World War I, and continues to stand to this day as the enduring legacy of the Mayo brothers and the ongoing mission of the Mayo Clinic. After reading up on this history lesson here in this abandoned hallway within the subway, I found out that I was underneath something called the Siebens Building. The city was vast and interconnected with tons of skywalks, probably more skywalks than there was subways. I knew that there was plenty of adventuring ahead, and it was already approaching the mid-afternoon, and I was ready to leave the subways and go explore more of Rochester, Minnesota. A thought crossed my mind as I made my way out of the deep underground chasm. What was the karaoke scene like here? After feeding my aunt's dog Poppy and searching around on Facebook for a little bit, I would discover a place called Charlie's Pub and Eatery, which was hosting a karaoke night that very night. This place was amazing. A good karaoke community, good beer, good eats, and everybody was having a great time. Know it at the time, but this girl that I recorded during Karaoke Roulette would also record me during my performance. I wouldn't meet her until later on that night, but her name is Nora. She's literally one of the coolest people I've met in my entire life and plays an integral role in Thayer's quest to the Midwest moving forward. Oh, and let's talk about Karaoke Roulette for a second, okay? Karaoke Roulette is basically this thing, separate from standard karaoke. You draw a random number out of a hat, and they give you a random song. Nora's was Dolly Parton's 9 to 5. I went up there like anybody else, drew my random number out of a hat, and the song that I got to play was Kelly Clarkson's Since You've Been Gone. Nora came up to me and told me how much she loved my performance. I told her that I loved her performance. And she asked me, hey, do you want to come with me and my friends Jen and Justin over to this place called Kathy's Pub? And me, I was like, Kathy's Pub? New friends? New cool friends in a state that isn't my own state? Texas to Minnesota? New friends in Minnesota? Heck yeah! Okay, well, I didn't say it exactly like that, but...
Woohoo! Darts! Darts.
Champions.
Gotta play some darts.
We haven't even played yet, but we're champions.
Gotta play darts in the Midwest with these two.
I'm gonna definitely do a lot better than her.
Yeah, we'll see. You haven't yet. Oh, okay. It's okay.
I'm not a quitter.
He's got that spirit of confidence about him. I love that.
So much ego that I'm gonna fail at. All right,
I guess. We did not end up playing darts, but I did meet the Grandmaster.
This is gambling.
They call this cardboard crack.
Okay.
It's literally crack.
Okay, you ready?
Yeah, it's literally crack.
Okay.
Okay.
It's literally crack. So, because it takes no fucking money to gamble money, big.
Yeah. That this is crack. I don't know if those are flavors of crack. I don't know.
So, okay. So, if you look at the side,
yeah,
it'll give you like what's available to win.
Okay.
Press the button. Okay, so this is all of my $11.
Okay.
So, because it's a dollar a spin. So, I got the Good Rockin' Daddy. This is what's left.
These are all games. It's like scratchies. Like
you win. Yeah, win money.
Okay.
Right?
Okay.
So you're going to pull one. I'm going to film you pulling one.
Okay. All right.
So there's three things.
And I pull this open. It just I don't scratch it up.
Nope. No. Pull it open.
Okay.
It's like cardboard. You just rip one by one.
Okay. So I got to match them. It's like a...
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, I mean, but you'll also see like an orange line.
Guys, I'm doing crack in the Midwest right now.
Yep.
Okay, we got a guitar, a clarinet, and an orange.
See, and you can mindlessly do these things. because if you win, there'll be like an orange line and it'll like tell you, so you can just like do it.
Okay, okay.
Yeah. My journey of Midwest crack and friendship continues in episode 6.